Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is Sebastian, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can quickly make a website in just under 15 to 20 minutes and take you step by step throughout this entire process. In fact, after you watch this entire video, you'll be able to make any kind of website just like this by using a simple drag and drop feature. That's right, there's absolutely zero coding required. So if you're a small business owner looking to make a website for your business, or just the average person looking to make your own blog or website for the very first time, then this tutorial is for you. So before we get started, just go ahead and click on the link below this video or on the call out right over here. To make this tutorial as easy as possible and frustration free, I've set up a companion page where you can follow along with the video. And in addition to the companion page, I've gone ahead and recorded an entire WordPress course absolutely free. Depending on when you're watching this video, there might be 20 videos or there might be 200 videos inside of the course. Now, I've covered the basics in this video to get your website up and running in about 15 to 20 minutes, but inside this free course, you'll see much more in detail how to do anything WordPress related, ranging from the most basic things such as adding a new page, all the way to more advanced customizations, and even how to start generating hundreds or even thousands of visitors to your website. And lastly, different strategies that'll show you how you can start making money from your new website if that's one of your goals. All right, so we've broken the process down into just four simple steps. Now, step one is to register your domain and to get web hosting. You can check if your desired domain name is available by typing it into the box here. Now, if your desired domain name is not available in a .com, you can see if it's available in a .co, .org, or a .net. Now, once you've found your domain name, it's time to get it registered and to set up your web hosting. Now, web hosting is a place where your website files will be stored. Things like images, videos, and the rest of your content. And before we continue, if you ever feel stuck or if you have any questions, just feel free to leave a comment down below the video and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Now, to sign up for hosting, scroll down the page and click on Get Hosting in a Free Domain. This is going to take you to the Bluehost signup page. Now, Bluehost is the web hosting provider that we'll be using for this tutorial. And in just a moment, I'm going to show you how to get Bluehost at the cheapest monthly rate anywhere for just $2.65 per month. Now, we've been using Bluehost for the past 5 years for all of our websites, and the reasons we continue to use them are because Bluehost is WordPress and beginner friendly, and not to mention they're the top recommended web host by WordPress. Now, you can also install WordPress with one click, making it the easiest and frustration-free way to integrate a web host in WordPress. Other platforms may require some additional technical steps, making things a bit more complicated. And things are gonna go wrong. I just wanna be straight up with you and not really sugarcoat anything. But if you do make a mistake, Bluehost has an amazing 24/7 support team, which you can easily reach out to via chat at any time and get virtually any problem fixed in under 5 to 10 minutes. And those are just some of the main reasons why we recommend Bluehost to anybody looking to get their website set up. Now, if you choose Bluehost as your web host provider, you'll receive a free domain, which typically goes for around $15 to $20 per year. All right, so on this page here, go ahead and click on the green Get Started button. It's gonna take you to this page where you can choose from the Basic, Plus, Choice Plus, or the Pro Plan. And to be honest, all you need is the basic package, especially if you're just getting started with your new website. So we'll just click on Select here, and it's gonna take us to this page here where we can put in our new domain name. For this example, I'm gonna be setting up a new website called makeawebsite.co, which is actually the website I've set up for this tutorial. Once you've entered your domain, just click on the blue next button. Awesome, so it looks like the domain is available. In order to get the special pricing of just $2.65 per month, scroll down on the page just a bit and then bring your mouse right over here above the domain bar and you'll see this pop up. This is gonna give you access to a special signup offer which gives you an additional 20% off, bringing the price down to just $2.65 per month. All you have to do is just click on the green claim savings button and the special offer is automatically applied. And if you scroll down here, you'll also notice that it's been applied. So on this page here, make sure to fill out all your information and from the package information section, choose how many months you'd like to purchase hosting for. Keep in mind that the more months you choose, the cheaper it'll be. Now, I'd say to go for as many years as you can afford, but even just a basic 12-month package is okay to get started. And I typically sign up for the basic 36-month package to lock in the price of $265 for the next 3 years. And as far as the extras go, the only one that I would recommend is the domain privacy protection, and it's just under $1 per month. Now, this helps you not receive any unwanted spam messages from people looking up your whois information for your recently purchased domain. And lastly, just fill in the billing information in order to complete the checkout process. Now keep in mind that you can make a payment either via your credit card or you can also use PayPal as well. Then just click on the checkbox here agreeing to the terms and Bluehost's agreements, and then just click on submit. And congratulations, you have now officially signed up for Bluehost's web hosting. You'll also be receiving a few emails from Bluehost with some important information, but from the thank you page, you'll need to click here and set your password that you'll be using to log into your Bluehost account. And after you're done setting up your email and going through Bluehost's welcome email, you should now be able to log into your account. All right, sweet. So it looks like we've successfully created our password. So just give this page a few seconds to load, but from here you can choose anything that you like. But for this tutorial, we're going to be choosing the Astra theme. That's what we're going to be working with throughout the rest of the tutorial. So click on use this theme. Just give it a few minutes to load, and from here we can go ahead and start building our WordPress website. All right, so after we click on start building, it's going to take us to the WordPress dashboard. Now I'll come back to this in just a moment, but it's pretty much just going to take us through a little setup process. As you can see, the first question here is what kind of site can we help you set up, but we'll get into that in just a moment. First off, let's take a look at the Bluehost dashboard. Now the Bluehost dashboard is going to be the easiest place to just go ahead and log into your WordPress dashboard. But as we can see here, we have my sites, we have the marketplace, email and office if you want to set that up. If you have any domains, any additional domains, which you can also add straight to this WordPress dashboard, and some more advanced settings that you can manage later on. Now, if we can go ahead and log into WordPress straight from here, so if we click on log into WordPress, we don't have to log in. It's actually going to log us straight into WordPress. And we're going to see the same exact screen that we saw right over here, just a little bit different layout, but it's going to ask us the same questions that it would right over here, and it's going to take us through the same step-by-step setup for WordPress. So I'm going to go ahead and go through this pretty quickly. So what kind of site can we help you set up? Now this depends on you, but for me, I'm going to go ahead and click on business. If you're starting a personal blog, then you can click on personal. So I'll go ahead and click on business. I'm just gonna skip through this real quick. All right, so here's the WordPress dashboard. And from here, you're gonna be able to control pretty much every aspect of your new site. Now, if you wanna access the WordPress dashboard again, just type in your website address followed by login. And I would also recommend bookmarking this page so it's easier to reach in the future. Now, again, an easy way to reach the WordPress dashboard is to also visit Bluehost and just click on login straight from the Bluehost dashboard. And honestly, it's as simple as that. Your site is now live. If you want to go ahead and check, just type in your domain into the search bar up here and click on enter. So as you can see, the site is live and it's already been uploaded with the Astra theme that we selected earlier. And in case you don't know, the theme of the website is the design of the website. It's what the website looks like. And in case you didn't choose the theme earlier, here's how to install a brand new theme. So head on over to the WordPress dashboard and on the left-hand column, click on themes. Now, once you're on themes, just click on add new, and in the search bar on the right-hand side, search for Astra. In order to install this theme, just hover over it and click on install. And once it's done installing, which should only take a few seconds, click on activate, and boom, the Astra theme should now be activated. You guys should all have it activated and installed and ready to use on your WordPress website. And as you can see, the appearance of the website isn't exactly as bad as the typical default theme that comes on WordPress, but it still looks pretty bad. So on the next step, I'm going to show you how to make it even more awesome. So now we're going to install a plugin which allows you to install an entire website in just one click and have it completely done and ready to go. Now this plugin also allows us to easily customize the theme. Now the process for installing a plugin is the same as installing a new theme. On the left hand side, click on plugins and then click on add new. In the search bar, type in Astra and then install the plugin by clicking install, and then activate it once it's done installing. Awesome, so it looks like the Astra site plugin went ahead and installed correctly. Now one of the things that I love about this plugin is that it has a set of pre-made designs that you can choose, which you can go ahead and apply to your own site. And before you do anything else, I would recommend heading over to pages here and deleting any pages that you might have. I just like to start with a clean slate whenever I'm building a new website, and it just helps keep everything neat and organized. So just click on the box over here next to title, and from the drop down, click on move to trash and then click on apply, and then head on over to the trash and do the same thing. Click the box and then from the drop down, this time click on delete permanently and then click on apply. All right, so now that we have no pages at all on our site, click on appearance and then on Astra sites. If you find that for whatever reason, there's no design showing, a quick and easy fix is to just uninstall the plugin and then reinstall it once again. In order to check those designs out and either get some inspiration for your website or just use one of those designs, click on See Library. So here are 14 beautiful pre-made designs that you can use for your website. This is a free version, but if you're interested, Astra also offers a paid version with even more pre-made designs in case you don't really see what you're looking for here. But if you're just getting started, these should honestly be more than enough. Now, before you choose a design, make sure you click on Elementor up here as it'll make it a lot easier to edit your design. So go ahead, click on Elementor, and from this page here, choose whichever design that you would like. Now I'm gonna go ahead and choose this design here, and once you click on it, you can always change it, but here's what the design looks like. Then head over to the left-hand column, and at the bottom here, click on Install Plugins. And once that's done, click on Import the Site. The cool thing is that the design and the demo content will be imported into your site, and I found that this always makes it easier to edit your website. And once the site import is done, we can actually view the site and see what it will look like. So it looks like the demo import was successful, and this is what your site should look like now. And not only did it import the homepage, but if you click on all of the other pages, you'll notice that it imported their design and demo content as well. So now that you've gotten your design chosen and imported and it's live on your site, it's time to get to the fun part and the final step of this tutorial, and that is to edit the content. In order to edit any of the pages on your site, just go to that page and make sure to click Edit with Elementor. For example, if we want to start editing the home page, we can either visit our site when we're logged in, or if you're on the WordPress dashboard, just head on over to the left-hand side, click on Pages, and then choose the home page. And from there, click on Edit with Elementor, and it'll take you to the same editing section. You can change anything you want on this page and any of the other pages simply by clicking on it and making the changes that you need to make. For example, if we want to move the text around, just click and hold the text and move it to another place. If you want to edit the text, just select it and change it to whatever you'd like. You can also change it in the left sidebar here. And you can also change the style of your text, including your font. If you want to make it bold, italic, underlined, or even if you want to link your text to another page on your site or another website completely. And if you want a more in-depth tutorial about the customizations that you can make, then make sure to visit the free course that I've set up down below for you. It goes much more in detail than I could go in this tutorial, to be honest. And once you're done with your changes, just click on the green save button and all of your work will be saved. And by clicking on the desktop icon, you can switch your page views and you can see what your page will look like in mobile or on a tablet as well. I'd highly recommend that you do this and take the extra time to make sure that your website looks great across all platforms, as more and more traffic coming to your site is predominantly mobile. Okay, so now that you know how easy it is to format and change any page on your website, we're going to take a look at how to edit the header or the footer area of your website. By using Elementor, you'll be able to change this part of the website and pretty much any other part of the actual content that's located on your website. But if you want to change the header or the footer, then you need to do that by going to the customize option. So if you're logged into WordPress and you visit your site, you'll notice that at the top, there's a link that says customize. That's going to open up this sidebar on the left where you can customize some of the overall features on your site, such as site identity, typography, menus, and widgets. But you'll also notice that in the header section, a few blue icons have popped up over here. So let's just go ahead and start with the logo. Just click on the blue pencil icon here, and it's going to open up on the left sidebar where you can edit your logo. What's really cool is that you can change the logos and put different sized logos depending on what type of computer somebody is visiting from, or you can even add a mobile logo so that your site looks great on mobile. Now, if you wanted to change the menu here or even the button in the header, again, just click on this little blue edit icon and you'll be able to edit it on the left sidebar. And the same goes for the footer area as well. If you want to change the logo, it's the same. If you want to add the links to your social media pages, just click on the blue icon and link out to your social media page. Even the text down here is super easy to change. And once you're done editing, you'll need to head on over to the top here and click on publish to make sure that all of the changes you made are now saved to your site. All right, so let's click on the little X button up here and head on back to our website. So now that you know how to edit the header and footer area, what if you wanted to add a new page? Or what if one of the templates that already comes with the site doesn't really have a page that you need? Well, it's actually super simple. From your website, hover on the new link located at the top right here and click on page. So let's just say that you wanted to create an about page for your website or a services page. Just enter the title of your page here, and in order to create the page and begin editing it, click on the button here that says Edit with Elementor. As you can see here, it's going to take you to the editor just like when we were editing the home page earlier, except this time the only content on the page is the header and footer, and you now have a blank space in between. So you have two options to get started with your page. You can either use the add section or add template section here, or you can also start dragging and dropping any of the elements on the left side into the blank space and start building your page that way. So first off, let's take a look at how to create your page using templates. Just like Astra and Elementor offer ready-made templates for an entire website, they also offer ready-made templates for pages, which you can import straight into your site. So let's go ahead, click on Add Template, and you'll find that there are a lot of designs here. And if there's any design that catches your eye and you want to see what it looks like, just click on it and it'll take you to a little preview page as you can see here. Now take a look at the whole design and see if that's what you're looking for your new page. And if you like it, all you have to do is click the green insert button right up here and it'll be directly added to your page. And just like that, in less than a few seconds, you'll see that we have the new design imported straight into our page. Now again, just as we did before, you can edit anything you want by selecting it and editing the element, or you can also drag new elements in from the sidebar and customize the page even further. And if there's any elements or even sections that you don't really like or need inside of your new page, you can just delete them with just one click. You can also feel free to move anything around and rearrange it to however you please, or you can also duplicate any element while building your site and pages. And once you're done with your changes, click save and view page. And that's it, guys. That's how easy it is to add a brand new page to your site. So by now, you should know exactly how to make your entire website starting from scratch. Make sure to click on the link below the video, find your perfect domain, and then from step two, get your hosting set up with Bluehost. Remember, you've got a special pricing and offer of just $2.65 per month that you can use, which is the absolute lowest price where you can get Bluehost anywhere on the internet. Anyways, that is it for today's video and tutorial. I'll see you guys in the next one.